Hi everybody, welcome back to my playthrough of Final Fantasy IV, and we've got more of the Lunar Subterranean to explore, so let's get going. And that was another battle there. Oh yeah, I got a white thing for it, so at this point I don't think I need white things. Well, getting near the end, there's still one part of the moon I haven't seen yet. Well, one part of the lunar subterranean. Yeah, I gotta fill out this map. Beat it. I don't have to go down the stairs quite yet. Well, normally in a regular playthrough, I would not have gone to the left, but because it's the first playthrough, and got a red bang, and Rosa gained a level. She's getting a bit more. That she needs. Head down. And before heading down that stairway. Yeah, I got B7 filled out and got coral whiskers. Now let's head down here. Ah, here we are. Lunar Subterranean B8. Yeah, this in the next few floors. If I remember right, the same music as the Giant of Babel, which is pretty awesome music in its own right. Yeah, I'm gonna put prey on Rosa finally. I don't think I need piercing magic around here. Let's start getting things filled out. And we run to Behemoths. Yeah, their random encounters starting in B8. And every random encounter from B8 on will have the regular boss music. So basically, I'm just showing this one to tell you that Behemoths are random encounters here. Let King cry his eyes out. Rosa with Kira. Think on everyone, because it just does physical attack. Well, P only attacks you physically. And yeah, let Rosa get tight and going. I got 50 shuriken left. Yeah, hopefully I can use them wisely. And Cecil's blink went out. Iridia gets another titan going. Just in case Blink goes down. Only point. That King's doing alright. Oh great, Cecil's Blink wore off, so hopefully this Behemoth goes down soon, but not going to, not like me. Sorry, I almost. Sorry, I've been speaking for a lot of episodes, so. Alright, Prey's working out. Gonna allow me to keep my MP topped off a bit. Especially at the high levels I have for Rosa. Oh, you shouldn't have done that. Behemoth got taken out with a counterattack. Alright, and Brady has gained a level. Oh yeah, I think everyone's about either at or above, well, except for Kane. Kane still needs a couple of levels to go. Yeah, this is where things can be really tough. Well, if you're not ready for them. There's a chest up there, but looks like another random encounter. And this is Death Mask, I believe. Yeah, it is. Normally he'll get an attack in before you, but what you do really depends on, well, what you do really depends on what he does first. Like, if he casts Reflect on himself, I think the way to go is use Reflect on you. I'm trying to remember what I did to him with the same way. Mainly, you want, if he casts Reflect, you want to get Reflect on someone else. Well, he's going to cast Reflect on you so that you can't heal yourself. But you can take advantage of it by casting Stop and having on one of your characters, and it'll reflect right back to him. Yeah, just like that. He's vulnerable to Stop, so you can take advantage of that. If I remember right, if he casts Reflect on himself, he'll cast Reflect on your party, and that's when you use Stop. There's also an instance where he'll use a beam attack on you. I forget what it's called, but it attacks the entire party, does good damage. And you don't need a Reflect to get Stop on him. And there's Rydia taking full advantage of multi-reflect to get a lot of damage on the Death Mask. I don't think he's vulnerable to anything. This might be me. Yeah, and taking advantage of that to get Libra on him, so when I face him anymore, I can use him. And I'm reflecting Berserk, so he can't use his beam attack, and it didn't work, so yeah, I'm still figuring some things out about the enemies, but Death Mask is gone. Mainly you want to try and get Stop on him. If he gets Reflect up, I would say wait for him to get Reflect up on your party members and take advantage of that. Now, of course you could use the spell and then use Then you stop, but I think that's more effective. And a couple more levels for Edge and Cecil. Well, one each for them. And also, if I didn't mention it during the Death Mask battle, all the new enemies get the boss music. Now there's still about a couple more, and also there's a sword here I wanted to at least prepare ahead before I take it on. Ah. It's Mune. See, we got Murasame, I believe that's me. We'll get Mazamune, and we got Ogopogo. Basically a dark version of Leviathan. It's got Deluge, which will hit pretty hard. Yeah, two of those will take us out, so basically get Bahamut going on Leviathan, Cecil can attack. Yeah, I'll just have Edge attack. I think I'm gonna try and save up this shuriken to get to the end. And Rosa heal everyone up and she'll cast slow. That's gonna really help out. So you get darkness on King so his jumps do more damage. Go Ridian. Wow. Max damage and a blaze counter. So. Alright, it's blaze is weaker than most, but Ridian is still taking a bit of damage. I think that deluge might take her out. Wow, it didn't. And she survived on 52 HP, I believe. So I definitely need to heal up. And now I'm going to get shell on everyone because I think that might help out with deluge and with the counter blaze. It doesn't look like Ogopogo's countering the physical attack, so that might take a while though. And now I want to try to get more healing and haste going at least. Alright, the shell kinda helped. But I wanna say it truly did. I think what's gonna help everyone is this haste. Alright, that should take care of Ogopogo. Haste didn't matter. Still a good spell, but ultimately Ogopogo goes down. Our party gains things. Well, Rosa gains a level, so that's good. He's gonna have high spirit by the time I get to the end. And we get to Masamune. I believe that's how it's pronounced. So of course, gotta get that on edge. Basically, he's gonna have the Murasame and the Masamune equipped. See, anything else I wanna change? No, I'll keep things the same. Yeah, so at this point, I'm trying to figure out what I'm going to do next. Well, I went back, did a little jump cut back to where I was before. I didn't really need to do that, just convenient. And let's keep going down, and yeah, that was another counter. Oh, I believe it was Behemoth because I got a headband out of it, and Edge gained a level. Also, oh yeah, now I remember what I did. I went back and saved just so I wouldn't have to do that part again. As you can see, Kane's now level 71. So the levels are there. And now we go down to B9. I forgot what item it was that we got for B8. Yeah, normally I would not have done that, except that first filling out maps. And you get a light curtain, and Cecil gains a level. He's level 75. Recording this kind of early enough in the morning where... Oh, there's a treasure chest in. So let's see what it is, and it's an elixir. Yeah, there's maybe a few chests left. There's no real big items being protected by major bosses, but yeah, and that was another behemoth, I believe, because I got a power sash, and Rosa gained a level, I think. Oh yeah, Rosa's level 75 also. And Cecil's gear is actually doing decent covering up. I think I decided to keep the black garb on edge. I think the power sash actually gives you a good, well, decent attack strength boost. Yeah, also gain levels for Iridia and King. So they're keeping up. Yeah, at this point I think you don't meet any more new enemies until D11. And get gold hourglass, so I think that's the best stop item in the game. And being eyes complete, we get some light curtains. And I run to a battle immediately. I get a power armlet, so yeah, I'm wondering if that, how good that would be. Oh wait, I decided to heal up first because I keep my HP top. Important for everyone to keep their HP. I think that was a death mask, I can't remember exactly. But it might have been Behemoth because physical counter. Alright, that was another battle and Edge gained a level. Oh, I got another power armlet. Monsters are making the drops for this area. Well, particularly Behemoth's fighting enough of them. Yeah, don't worry, we're near the end. There's a chest, but it's down here. And that's another Fuma Shuriken. That's going to come in handy. Oh, and another random battle, and a level up, and a light curtain. I think that one was a death mask there. Oh, and I run into another random battle. I seem to be running into him. Rosa's now level 76. So that's good. Alright, there's an elixir. Just gotta try and get figure out where I'm going next. Yeah, I decided to go that way to fill out the map. Had another battle and Iridia and Kane both gain levels. So they're doing well. Yeah, I believe it was after that I decided that Cecil needed to heal us up, so that's what he did. Yeah, just fill out that part of the map. Alright, that should complete B10, and for that we get 3 Stardust. That's actually a nice item to have. And now we're in B11, the Lunar Subterranean, and this is really the final level of the place, so once we get to the end, we'll be near the end of the game. We'll finally get to face Zemus, but before that, we got a new enemy here. I believe that's Zemus's breath. I want to check and make sure. Yeah, he can be stopped too, and it's Zemus's breath. His main thing is going to be casting Libra on you, so in a way, he's kind of Zemus's scout. I also like to think that Zemus's breath is either so strong or so bad that it reaches the entire level of the subterranean. Yeah, you can smell him from a floor away. Or it could be that he's just so powerful that his own breath can take form and be a monster. Wow, think that did a lot of damage. Forget what it was, it might have been Flare, right? Try and pay attention to the video and all that. And I figure I'd cast Libra so I could get its stance for future. I mean, we're not too in. And I want to see what Holy could do. They're good. Alright, that takes care of Zemus's breath. Alright, team did good there. The breath isn't much to worry about. I think the one to worry about is, well, it's going to be in this video as well. If I run into it, and I did. And I did get a preemptive strike at least, so. A lot of good that day. If you're wondering, that's Zemus's malice. Yeah, this one will attack you. Imagine having so much hate that it can take a physical form. Yeah, I want to get Libra in just to make sure I know when it's going to go down. Yeah, I also want to keep Cecil's HP up. This battle might take a while, but not really much to it. Just can't stop. If you really think about it, the death mask, Zemus's malice and Zemus's breath can all be stopped. So just have that ready. Cecil top himself off. EHD department, and we're close to the end. Oh, and I had another battle there. I forget what it was. Well, what I was against, and wow, you can see the core of the moon there. We're right here, right at the center of it. And we finished B11 and we get 3 Lunar Curtains. And also we finished every map in the game and get the Treasure Hunter Augment. You know, that thing is pretty nice. It doubles the rate at which items drop. Well, it doubles the rate. So if you have 0.4% chance, it's now 0.8. 1% is now 2%. So on and so on. And it turns out I never really got used for Iridia's, well, for playing Bard Song on Iridia, but that's just me. And well, I gotta get ready for Zemus because once we go down those stairs, we're gonna face him. So next episode, that's what we're gonna do. And I might try another shot at the Flame Princesses before then. But until next time, have a good day and thanks for watching.